Drama over the arrest of Cleveland Mayor Frank Jackson's 22-year-old grandson, Frank Q. Jackson, is reaching a crescendo tonight.
City of Cleveland's law department is explaining why Jackson didn't end up behind bars earlier for that June assault, causing the county to step in. Our Five on Your Side investigator, Joe Paganakis, live in the newsroom right now. Joe, city prosecutors are blaming CMHA detectives.
Rob, that statement was issued just a few hours ago, and it was the U.S. Marshal's Office that finally had to call Cleveland Mayor Frank Jackson to help them make a peaceful arrest.
I told him, hey, Pete Elliott, U.S. Marshal, I'd like you to, your grandson has a warrant for him. I want him to peacefully surrender.
U.S. Marshal Pete Elliott explains how he made the call to Cleveland Mayor Frank Jackson to arrange the arrest of Mayor Jackson's grandson, Frank Q. Jackson. The grandson, now in jail, charged with four felony counts in connection with the alleged beating of an 18-year-old woman in June. Elliott says the phone call to Mayor Jackson was critical in making the arrest without incident.
And I believe we made the right decisions at the right time.
But it took a Cuyahoga County grand jury and a county arrest warrant to get Frank Q. Jackson charged and arrested. And now, the Cleveland City Law Department Criminal Division Chief Kerry D. Howard explaining why the Cleveland City prosecutor declined to charge Jackson, saying, quote, every charging decision is made based on the facts and evidence presented to an assistant prosecutor by a presenting law enforcement official. A CMHA detective failed to provide all the evidence related to this matter. When facts and evidence are withheld, such as the video released yesterday, an educated and informed decision cannot be made. But this CMHA report and pictures of the woman's injuries were enough evidence for the Cuyahoga County prosecutor to go to a grand jury, including this video that police say shows Jackson's truck leaving the scene of the alleged assault. The county prosecutor's office explaining why it moved forward earlier, saying, quote, there are concerning facts in this case, including repeated strangulation of the victim and flight to evade police, which are known to be factors suggesting the victim could be at risk of a future lethal or near-lethal assault.
And we contacted CMHA police for a response on the Cleveland Law Department's comments, but we're still waiting for a call back. Jackson will likely spend the weekend in jail. He's set to be arraigned on the four felony counts against him on Monday. Live in the newsroom, I'm 5 on Your Side investigator Joe Paganakis.